grass at Legion Field that was actually put in for the 1996 Olympic soccer matches. This field.
Here it is, the second Saturday in October. That means the traditional Alabama-Tennessee game is only 1 week away. Right? Wrong. For the first time since 1914, the game is not on the third Saturday. It's today. For Tennessee fans, winless in 9 years, anything is a good omen. For Alabama fans, the response is simple. It's not the date. It's points that count. True enough. Yet when SEC football aficionados talk about tradition, Bill Anderson, for many, that tradition is the crimson, the big orange, the third Saturday.
No question about that, John. Nobody's waiting till next week. The time is now. It's here. Legion Field sold out as Tennessee fans this year saying, you know, it's our turn. And Alabama said, we've heard that before. And you don't know what's going to happen. But Tennessee versus Alabama, that's football tradition at its finest.
And so we're set to begin. Deep for Tennessee, Sean Summers, who on the year is averaging right at 24 yards per return. And he's standing back at his goal line. Tennessee fans, for those of you interested in knowing, are basically seated in the northeast corner of the football field. The Pride of the Southland Band is here and will be performing at halftime, as will the Million Dollar Band of the University of Alabama. Now the officials have been advised that the game is set to get underway. And so here it is. Tennessee and Alabama, and the kick comes downfield. He hits it well, a squibber that goes bouncing through and out of the end zone, meaning Tennessee will put the ball in play first down at Sendigo at the 20-yard line. For Tennessee, the quarterback will be Peyton Manning, 6'5", 202 sophomore from New Orleans. He has thrown for 11 touchdowns, has had three passes intercepted. At tailback for Tennessee, Jay Graham, 148, 732, his total yardage, averaging just under 5 yards per carry. Alabama lines up in a four-man front. No, they shift into a three-man front against Tennessee. The Volunteers with a single running back, that being Graham. So there's a tight end for the Vols to the right side. This will be Manning. Back to throw. Across the middle. Pass complete. Ball down at the 35, to the 40, to the 45, to the 50, to the 45, to the 40, to the 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. What did he do? All he did was score. Joey Kent. Touchdown on play number one. Peyton Manning. Joey Kent from Huntsville, Alabama, and he races downfield to score untouched, turning on the speed, Bill Anderson, along the near sideline.
He came with a three-man rush. He had time back there. He just caught him in there on the kind of a deep turn-in. He was almost slowed down to a stop, and when he got that ball, it was outrun everybody.
So Tennessee will have in to attempt the extra point, Jeff Hall. It's up. The kick is good. 14 seconds have gone. Tennessee leads by a score of 7-0, Bill Anderson, on just a brilliantly executed play, and Tennessee picked up the change in the Alabama defense, and then 14 seconds into this game, 80 yards, Tennessee on top, 7-0.
Made that one look easy, John. They really did. Joey Kent caught the ball and then just turned the speed on and let it rip. He brought it back across the field, brought it all
wing off. Hall hits it downfield, racing up to pull it down at the 15. Alabama to the 20, to the 25, out to the 30-yard line, and then he will be pounded down as returning the ball was for Alabama Fegan. He is initially stopped by Ronnie Pillow. Relatively short kick, but keep in mind it was Hall kicking into a 10 to 20 mile wind. Alabama goes on offense, so let's set the backfield as Tennessee leads 7-0. Brian Bergdorf, 6'2", 206 senior from Cedartown, Georgia, will be at quarterback. The tailback will be Dennis Riddle at 6'1", 190. The fullback is Ed Sism, 6'2", 210, a freshman. Alabama comes in the I formation with Riddle at tailback. Flankers left and right against a five-man Tennessee front. Back to throw, Bergdorf. Screen pass to the near side. Pulled down there by Riddle, who turns the corner to the 30, to the 35, to the 40, and he's shoved out of bounds very, very close to a first down by Deron Jenkins. As Riddle, wandering out of the backfield, took the pass on a little flare or screen-type play wide and moved it past the 40-yard line, and it is not quite a first down. Second down, about a foot to go. Tennessee 7, Alabama nothing. As Tennessee scored on its first play from scrimmage, going 80 yards on a pass from Manning to Kent. For Manning, his 12th touchdown pass of the year. For Kent, his 5th. Alabama comes with a power set into the boundary right. And this will be the tailback nosing over right guard and driving for 3 or 4 yards, certainly enough for the first down. Scott Galyon is there to make the tackle. For Tennessee defending, it will be at the ends in the front four, Leonard Little and Steve White. The tackle, Shane Burton and Ron Green. The linebackers, Anthony Hampton, Tyrone Hines, Scott Galyon. The cornerbacks, Deron Jenkins and Terry Fair. The safeties, Torrey Noel and Raymond Austin. Alabama, first down, 10 to go, at its own 43-yard line, trailing 7 to nothing. Bergdorf faces a four-man Tennessee front. Out of the I formation, gives to Riddle. Riddle tries left guard, not much there, as penetrating Ron Green, the freshman, is there to knock him down after a gain of about a yard. Bill?
Well, John, it opened with a lot of fireworks, I'll say that. I think that surprised everybody, including me. They came out with that, hit that big play, and a great job of Joey Kent just breaking that thing for the score, because Alabama's defense was spread all over the field and there was a lot of running room in there, but he did a beautiful job of doing it.
It's Alabama, second down, right at 9 yards to go, trailing 7-0. The ball at the tied 44-yard line. Tennessee on top, Alabama with the ball. They'll run Riddle as a man in motion from left to right. Back to throw. This will be Bergdorf with time. Pumps now across the middle. Pass is incomplete. Tennessee had him pretty well protected by a linebacker. It was Riddle who was picked up by a linebacker coming out of there, Scott Galyon. And Galyon had him, so he had to, as the quarterback Bergdorf had some time, turn to come back to the ball, and simply it was thrown a little wide and goes incomplete. So here it is, third down and 9 to go.
Tennessee stepping up in there and getting some pretty good penetration that time against the run, Johnny. Wasn't much of a much running room there at all.
And so here's Alabama going into a shotgun situation with Bergdorf, some 6 yards deep. Tennessee stays with a four-man line. Bergdorf being pressured, pass downfield is complete. It's yanked down there by Ed Sisson, the fullback, who makes the catch at midfield and maneuvers on to a little beyond the 48-yard line. He's tackled as he gets there by Steve Johnson and Tyrone Hines. It is short of a first down by a yard. Fourth down and 1. And Alabama initially got its punting unit out onto the field. Then they returned to circle around the special teams coach. Now it will be the punting team out there with Hayden Stockton ostensibly to punt, and deep for Tennessee, Summers at his 10. Tennessee 7, Alabama nothing. Snap, punt away. High one. Summers under it, camps and lets the ball bounce, and it kicks out of bounds brilliantly as the bounce goes out at the 6-yard line. Make it the 7. The 7-yard line, brilliant punt by Alabama. Tennessee lines up at an I formation with Jay Graham at tailback. He's standing 1 yard deep in the end zone as Alabama comes with a 5-man front. Manning checking off at the line for Tennessee. Turns and looks to the fullback. The crowd is alive. This will be Manning giving to Graham. Tries the left side, breaks it. This is Graham. Has the ball at the 8. Has the ball at the 10. Has the ball at the 15. And fights his way to the 16-yard line where Cedric Samuel makes the tackle. Great block on the left side by Smith and Lehman.
Yeah, they opened a nice hole in there, Johnny. Alabama jumped everybody up there on the line, and when he popped the crack there, he had good running room for a win.
It's about a yard shy of a first, actually a little less than that, as Tennessee comes to the line again. And the Volunteers at the 16-yard line, fullback carrying the ball through the left side, fighting forward will be Chester Ford. He scrambles out to the 17. There's a scramble, possibly. We'll wait and see. The officials asking for timeout, which would indicate to me that the clock has been stopped with a marking of a first down big on it. Kendrick Burton was there to make the tackle. On the year, Alabama plus 6 in turnovers, Tennessee plus 2. First and 10 for the Volunteers. Spot the ball at the Tennessee 18-yard line with the balls on top of the Crimson Tide, 7-0. Tennessee comes with two wideouts to the left side, a single receiver to the right. Pitch will go to Graham, looking to the near side, not much there. Turns upfield and battles for 2 yards, and then really is popped by Ralph Statton, the linebacker on the right side. Tennessee leading 7-0. First quarter of the game at Birmingham. Manning sizing up the defense. It's a four-man front. Manning, play action, pass upfield, is pulled down by the tight end, Scott Pfeiffer, who makes the catch up to the 22-yard line, is shoved back downfield, but his progress will give him a 2-yard pickup. 6 yards to go for Tennessee. Alabama rushing with Burton, Brown, Parker, and Moore. On the year, they have 23 sacks. Manning is going to set up in the shotgun. Alabama set to rush. The Volunteers have a slot man on the right side in the person of Staley. Here's the pass to Staley. It is complete. He yanks it down at the 29-yard line, and that will be enough for the first down. I said Staley. It was actually Marcus Nash who was sliding over there, and Tennessee has it. First down and 10 to go.
That's all they need. That was a good job of running the route. Got just enough to get the first down, and one thing Tennessee started doing, and I think that's very smart, John, is trying to throw in a quick count. They just hit the short routes, and that takes away the effectiveness of the Alabama rush. They can't get too patent if they throw those routes.
It's first and 10 for Tennessee. Two wides to the right, two to the left, single running back Jay Graham against a four-man front. Alabama rotating its defensive secondary to the left side as Manning fades to throw. Pass down and out is going to be complete to Tennessee at the 35, to the 40, to the 45, to the 50, to the 45, to the 40. This is Ronnie Pillow, who carries the ball to the 35-yard line. Well, Deshay Townsend gambled. He has an interception. This time the gamble did not pay off, and Pillow maintained the concentration. After the break for the interception, Pillow moves downfield.
Well, that's what happens. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. That time he went for the interception. As you said, John, just simple turnout. He had the Pillows covered very well out there. He went for the pickoff. He didn't get to it. Pillows picked up big yard.
36 yards, first in Tennessee at the Alabama 35-yard line. Back to a single running back, that's Graham. Alabama fading the blitz, here it comes. Tennessee sets up a screen, pull down at the 35, down to the 30, and fighting his way to the 28-yard line goes Marcus Nash. So Manning felt the blitz, he just stood, flipped quickly, Nash pulled it down, got a block at the line, slid inside, and then powered his way for an extra 2 yards before Fernando Bryant made the tackle on him. So Marcus Nash, with two catches, now has 29 on the year and has gone over 300 yards total reception as the sophomore receiver from Tulsa. Tennessee substituting as Pillow comes out. Thus far, Manning 5 of 5 for 131 yards and a touchdown as Tennessee leads 7-0. For the Vols, second down and 4 at the 29-yard line of Alabama. Ball on the left hash mark. Manning, screen pass the other way. He has the ball at the 25. Fighting for the first down will be Joey Kent. Stanton makes the tackle on him, but I think he got enough for the first down as Tennessee Bill, just as you pointed out, snap flip,
and that takes away the rush by the Alabama defense. They're trying to get to Manning. They're frustrated a little bit back there, looks like, because he's been able to hit these passes. I think he's got the first down, John.
They will be asking for a measurement, apparently. Alabama is coached by Gene Stallings. Completed passes for 2, for 7, for 36, for 6, now for 4. And with the Vols leading by a score of 7-0, Tennessee has the ball at the tied 25-yard line. Again, the Vols send two wide receivers to the left side, a single one to the right. This is Manning off play action across the middle. He's dropped as it was caught by Maurice Staley at the 20-yard line. And as he then makes his first stride, getting actually down to the 15, he lost the handle. For Tennessee, it will be second down and 10, leading in the football game with 8:05 to go in the first quarter, 7-0. The Vols will skip a man in motion from right to left. Joey Kent back to throw. This will be Manning against the blitz. Tennessee spells it. He has the ball on the pass down to the 30, to the 25, to the 20, to the 15, to the 10. Well, you count it off. Touchdown, Big Orange. There is a penalty marker down. Tennessee might have been moving, might have been illegal procedure. I'll see. Backfield in motion, Tennessee. So the touchdown is nullified as Tennessee was running the man in motion. Bill?
What a beautiful play, John. I know that thing. I couldn't tell if they were in motion or not. I didn't pick it up, but it was set up beautifully. They caught him in the blitz. Everything worked to perfection except the flag.
So Tennessee, apparently a touchdown. It will be wiped off, and here's the call.
Have illegal motion against the offense, movement at the snap. 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
So Tennessee will have it second down and 15, an apparent touchdown nullified. And the Volunteers huddling it up as the ball is moved back to the 30-yard line. That play was just a thing of beauty as Tennessee went on the touchdown pass, apparently, from a Manning to Jay Graham, who was the screen recipient against the blitz out to the right side. But all for naught. Tennessee will now have it second down and 15. Manning brings his team to the line, may go into a shotgun. That apparently will be the situation as Manning is back there. Standing beside him will be Jay Graham. Here is the contact in the line before the ball was snapped. Go to the first quarter. Tennessee, two flankers right, one to the left. Manning in the shotgun. Graham back there with him. Four-man front, Alabama. Here they come. Manning setting up. Pass downfield is incomplete. Intended for Joey Kent. Well defended across the way. Had his hands on the ball for just a moment. But battling and stripping him down was Brad Ford. And so Tennessee, keep in mind, heading into the teeth of a wind from 10 to 20 miles in strength. So the Vols have it third down and 10 at the 25-yard line of Alabama. This drive now 11 plays. Tennessee scored its touchdown on the first play of the ball game, 80 yards, Manning to Kent. Now Tennessee will flood the left or wide side of the field with three receivers. Alabama stays with four down linemen. This is Manning. Here's the pressure. Here's Manning down into the end zone. That touchdown pass is caught. I knew he had it. Marcus Nash, touchdown, Big Orange.
Well, they deserve that one, John. I really thought that one they called back. That one was hard to see any emotion in that one, but they hung in there. Great job by Peyton. They got a little bit of pressure on him that time. He stepped up in there. Beautiful throw right to the corner.
Great throw. Sensational catch, and you felt it. Nash was not to be denied. He made the catch and strides just by the pylon. Here is Hall for the extra point. Down, kick is up. Did he make it? He made it. Tennessee leads by a score of 14 to nothing with 7:42 to go in the first quarter of this football game. 29 on the year to kick off. Deep will be West and Fagan for Alabama. The last scoring drive for Tennessee, 11 plays and 93 yards, 4 minutes 52 seconds, the length of the drive. The first drive, one play, 80 yards, 14 seconds. This will be Hall. Kicks it, hits this one well into the wind. Alabama camps under the ball at the goal line. He's to the 5, to the 10, to the 15, and he is batted out of bounds as he moves just beyond the 20-yard line. So, down to make the tackle, Torrey Noel on West. James that Fagan, who returned the ball. And so Alabama will go on offense first, down at 10 to go. As they spot it, we'll wait till they put the ball down. Tennessee is coached by Philip Fulmer in his third year. His record, 26-7-1. So he's won 78%. His teams have won 78% of the games during which Fulmer was the head coach. We'll check the staff in a moment as Alabama lines up, and it's just shy of the 20-yard line. First down and 10. Bergdorf, off play action, back to throw. Pass down and out is yanked down by the tailback wandering to the left side, Dennis Riddle, who makes the catch at the 24 and moves forward to the 26-and-a-half-yard line. Bumped out of bounds by Terry Fair. On offense, Tennessee relies on Alabama, now into a shotgun. It will be second down right at 3 yards to go as Bergdorf gives that shovel pass through, and Tennessee was waiting on it. Bill? We watched that on TV today, and you called it.
That's the first time in 10 years we have stopped that pass. They have killed us with it and killed us with it. We were talking about it before the game.
That the quarterback, Bergdorf, up under the center. And Bergdorf is blasted, fumbles the football. There's a scramble for it at the 24-yard line. Who has recovered the ball? The Big Orange, Bill Duff. And somebody just lowered the boom as Bergdorf came out on the option, and it was Leonard Little who just cracked him.
Yeah, he popped him as soon as he came away from the center, Johnny. I mean, he had his headgear right in there on his chest in the ball, and it just popped loose. Big play, great opportunity for the ball.
Tennessee leading by a score of 14 to nothing. Tennessee will have the ball at the 24-yard line of Alabama after the Tide loses the fumble, and that will be the fourth fumble lost by Alabama this year. Tennessee to the line. Two receivers left, one to the right. Graham the tailback now against the five-man front. Manning setting up the throw. Pass downfield is incomplete. It was momentarily caught by Nash, but as he made his move to the interior, he had the ball. Then it popped up. He tried to reach and grab it like a rebound. Not to be. It will be second down.
Well, they were coming at Peyton pretty hard. They just automatic went on that quick slant inside. He read him and got the ball to him. Had he been able to hold on to it, it would have been big yardage, but the ball was a little bit behind, John.
So it's got to be second down and 10 for Tennessee, leading 14 to nothing. 6:47 to go in the first quarter. Kent wide to the right. Out there with him, the tight end. Two receivers left. Graham, the tailback, a four-man front. This is Manning setting up. Pass is going to be deflected down, as it was Manning intending the pass, I think, for Graham, but it was deflected down by Dwayne Rudd, the linebacker. The Volunteers at the Alabama 24 against a three-man rush, anticipating the pass. Graham, the tailback. Manning, there's the screen to Graham, pulls it down at the 30, to the 25, to the 20. Fights his way as he dives down close. Let's see how far he got. It appears to me he's at the 13-yard line. He needed to get to the 14. What an effort by Jay Graham. They line it up. They're talking about it. It is first down, Tennessee.
Big play. Nice play through it. Coming out of the backfield. He just started out there. Graham just on a little bit of a flare pattern, dumped it off to him and let him run with it.
So it was Jay Graham after the pass dumped out to him in the flat by Manning, who really turned it on at the corner, and he dived for the first down. Seven first downs for Tennessee to this point, leading 14 to nothing. Here are the Volunteers inside the 15-yard line of Alabama. It will be first down and 10. Alabama four-man front. Tennessee gives to Graham. Strikes right, cuts left. This is Graham fighting his way. He's at the 13, spins and fights down inside the 10 to the 9, and a penalty flag is dropped at that point. Ralph Statton finally made the tackle on him, but Graham got a big swath through the left side. Again, I would assume it's Lehman and Rito blocking. A penalty marker down on the play at the 9-yard line. Tennessee 14, Alabama nothing. Here's the ball at the Alabama 4-yard line, first down and goal. Tennessee scored, for those of you who joined us late, on the first play from scrimmage, 80-yard pass play, Manning to Kent. And then Tennessee, after a fine punt by Alabama's punter Stockton that went out of bounds at the 7-yard line, Tennessee marched 93 yards in 11 plays with a touchdown coming this time on a pass from Manning to Nash. Tennessee in a power eye set to the right side. Running back split. Manning gives off. Driving to the right side. This is Graham, who catapults from the 4 down to about the 1-yard line. And he just rode over Big Jeff Smith and Robert Poole. And Graham comes down in the arms of Walters, but he was able just to soar for about 2.5 yards.
Yeah, that was a nice surge over there by the right side of Tennessee's offensive line. They moved some people back. They got Graham got up on top. He came down. He couldn't get all the way over the crest to go into the end zone, but they certainly moved it forward.
4 carries, 19 yards for Graham. Tennessee now to the old-fashioned straight T formation. Alabama into a 7-man front. Breaking the T, moving to the right side. Tennessee gives to the fullback and cracking up the middle. This will be Chester Ford. He was able to get about a yard, no more than that. And so Tennessee leading 14 to nothing will have it third down in about 2 feet to go. Good play in the middle by Kendrick Burton, defending along with Shannon Brown on the left side for Alabama. Alabama leads the series. Did I say third down? It should be third down. It should be third down. Impossible. Tennessee to the line. The Volunteers with the football. This is Manning. It is second down, apparently. This will be Graham. No, it's Manning on the naked handoff, reverse to the left side. Nobody even knows who's got the ball except Peyton Manning. He's got the ball, and where is he? In the end zone for 6.
1 yard and a touchdown.
Everybody went with Graham through the right side, and Manning just played it so brilliantly. Gave no indication, Bill.
No, great fake. They got it from the back, the offensive line, everybody. A beautiful fake. Manning just stood there for a moment, let him follow through with it, then just bootlegged out the backside, fooled everybody.
Didn't matter whether it was second or third. It's got to be Hall to attempt the extra point. It's in the air, and this time the kick by Jeff Hall is good.
Kick is good.
5:04 to go in the first quarter of this football game. Tennessee leads 21 to nothing.
Alabama
received a penalty of half the distance to the goal on a first down play. It was at the 5-yard line, and it was at that point first down and 1, not first down and goal. Tennessee on the first play, diving was Graham. He got a first down, and so it was on the second down touchdown run by Manning that Tennessee leads 21 to nothing. Kickoff coming downfield, pulled down by West of Alabama. He turns it on down the left side to the 20, to the 25, to the 30. This is West to the 35, and finally he's blocked out of bounds by Tennessee's Ronnie Pillow and also Deron Jenkins, but not until Alabama has excellent field position at the 39-yard line. So here's the way it's gone. Tennessee on the first play from scrimmage, 80 yards on a touchdown pass Manning to Kent. Alabama unable to move, punts. Tennessee sees the ball go out of bounds at the 7. 93 yards, 11 plays, touchdown goes Manning to Kent. To Nash. Alabama fumbles, Tennessee recovers. 3 plays later, the Volunteers score, leading 21-0. Freddie Kitchens is the quarterback for Alabama. This is Kitchens off play action. Back to pass. Kitchens in trouble. Breaks out of there. Will run with the ball. Tennessee had 3 men on him. And as he comes lumbering forward, he gets to the 40 and falls down at the 45-yard line with Hines there to pin him, placing the starter, Brian Bergdorf. It will be 2nd down, 5 yards to go, Alabama. Kitchens again back to throw. Pass to the near side, pulled down behind the line by Riddle. Gets to the corner, and then is somersaulted down as he moves past the 45 to the 47 by a slashing Raymond Austin. 10-second station identification. Legion Field in Birmingham. This is John Ward and Bill Anderson sending you the play-by-play of the Southeastern Conference game, which finds Tennessee leading Alabama in the first quarter, 21-0. Alabama will have the ball 3rd down and 3 yards to go. Running backs are split. Kitchen back to throw. Pumping, looking. He is going to come running out of there with the football and is chased down and tackled from the back by Shane Burton, short of the 1st down. The Volunteers had them covered downfield and again had pressure on him almost for the sack. He escaped, but Burton chased him down.
Yeah, they're going to have
the 1st down.
Going to have to punt. I tell you what I think's happening here already, John. It's 21 points this quick. Tennessee's getting Alabama kind of out of their game plan. They've got a new quarterback in there starting to try to throw the ball more.
Here's Stockton into punt. His last punt went out of bounds at the Tennessee 7. Snap, punt is away. High, relatively short. Chasing it will be Summers, and he lets the ball skip out of bounds. And it's another fine punt inside the 20 as it ricochets out of bounds. At this point, Tennessee 133 yards, Alabama 39 yards. Tennessee leads 21-0. At quarterback, Peyton Manning, 6'5", 202 sophomore. Thus far in the ballgame, he's 8 of 12 for 170 yards. Tennessee goes into an I formation against a 4-man defensive front. Ball on the right hash mark. Snap pass, pull down on the far side, and yanking it down over there is Andy McCullough, who makes the catch of the 20, tries to skitter his way forward, but is knocked out of bounds to stop. For Tennessee, a gain of 3. 2nd down and 7. Quick count. Handoff Graham comes to the near side. In trouble. Escapes one man. Still on his feet. Turns upfield and fights to the 25. Struggling there. People trying to pull the ball away from him, but the whistle had sounded. The whistle had sounded. Alabama has picked up a loose ball and goes racing into the end zone. But the whistle had sounded as Dwayne Rudd ends up with the ball. Graham, as we said, struggling, and Alabama there stripping. But the whistle was sounding, and it will be Tennessee with the ball at the 25-yard line. And 4 yards to go for Tennessee. Extra effort by Graham. Ronnie Pillow has come on to replace Graham at tailback. A good pass receiver. Alabama creeps the linebacker up on Manning in the middle. And he's coming after him as Tennessee gives the ball off to Pillow through the right side. And he nice forward to about the 28-yard line. A penalty marker is dropped at that point. A fumble occurs, and Alabama has recovered the ball with Dwayne Rudd getting it. So the turnover goes Alabama's way this time. The Tide trailing 21-0. Kitchens is still there at quarterback. Into an I formation, and the pitch will go to Riddle. Riddle coming to the near side, looking for a block, gets to the corner, but is knocked down. Little, if any, yardage on the play, as Raymond Austin strings it out and makes the tackle after a gain of maybe 0.5 yard on it. And Riddle. Riddle is to the right side. Tennessee, 4 men to rush. Back to throw. This is Kitchen. Pass across the middle is incomplete. Thrown behind a slanting wide open Todrick Malone, and it will be 3rd down. Sending wide to the left side, Malone. To the near side comes the leading receiver, Brown. Quarterback is Kitchen. Tennessee, 4 men rush. Back to throw, Kitchens. Kitchens with time. Pass is caught. Great move made by Alabama's Todrick Malone, who makes his move on a reverse pivot at the 25. Moves to the 20, down to the 15, and is tackled at the 14-yard line. He was defended by Torrey Noel, but he put a beautiful move on with a reverse pivot, and Alabama has it 1st down and 10 to go.
Yeah.
Back into an I formation. Riddle is the tailback. This will be the give to Riddle, and Riddle finds running room through the left side, and he dives from the 14 to the 10, and he's pinned at that point by Tennessee's Jesse Sanders, who's in there as a linebacker. That could very well be the final play in the first quarter of this football game. As the seconds tick away, Tennessee came out just unrelenting and move for 3 touchdowns to lead at the end of the first quarter, 21-0. A break for our stations by telling you the score again at the end of the first quarter. Tennessee 21, Alabama nothing.
to put a little play.
Nothing.
To put a little play action on it or something, or and throw the deep one. They're moving up. They're really getting close up on him.
In the first quarter, Tennessee, 8 minutes, 7 seconds. Alabama, 6:53. Alabama now here to begin the second quarter, moving toward the north end of the football field. Tennessee shifts its defense as Alabama has Kitchens back to throw. He's in deep trouble, fumbles the ball. There's a scramble for it at the 14-yard line. And as Tennessee pops in there, I think it's going to be ruled as a fumble, and it has been recovered by Tennessee. Jesse Sanders is the guy who forced the fumble, and it was recovered by Shane Burton. But Sanders, as they shifted the defense, Bill, and he came with the blitz, and Kitchens was popped, dropped, recovered by Burton.
They had that play from something they picked up. They read the deep. They had the defense in great shape. They were coming with, looked like a flood screen out to the right side. Everybody was out there. The defense took it away from him, and he got hit, stripped from the back before he could throw. He tried, wanted to throw the ball, couldn't, and then about that time he got stripped.
So Alabama turns it over for the second time in this game, and Tennessee stops the drive, at least temporarily, and the Volunteers hand the ball at the 14-yard line. Again, they bring those linemen up very, very tight. Manning, off play action, back to throw. Manning across the middle. Pass is, oh, what a catch. Did he hold onto that football? Complete! What a grab by Marcus Nash! Juggling it at the 25, hell onto that ball. I was screened by Nash himself, and his hands were out in front. He made the catch, and it's first down.
He was covered pretty well, too, coming across the middle. That was a terrific throw. Peyton let him out there. He had to stretch for it. He got it, and as you said, John, he juggled it, but he was able to stay after it until he came up with it.
First down, Tennessee at the 31-yard line of the Volunteers, leading 21-0. Alabama back to a more conventional four-man front. Tennessee runs a man in motion. The give this time comes to Jay Graham, and there's nothing there at all for the tailback as they're grabbing and trying to strip, and Graham is primarily concerned at this point with holding onto the football. Kelvin Moore there to make the tackle on him. Nothing at all. Maybe a loss on the play. Over the defense has decided what the play will be. They're bringing everybody. Could be a blitz. It will be Manning juggling the ball, picks it up, will run. Manning scampers forward to the 29-yard line as the snap was fumbled, as Alabama had people dancing all over the place, and Dwayne Rudd was coming after him, and so the ball fumbled. Manning picked it up and moves it back to the line of scrimmage. Sends three wide receivers to the left side. Alabama, again, those linebackers, here they come, everybody. It's the pass by Manning under pressure, intending the pass quickly to Staley, but not to be, as he was rushed so much that he had to just rip the ball quickly. Staley never had a chance to get it. And so Alabama putting the pressure on, really gambling defensively, but coming after Tennessee with everybody. And it will be fourth down, and here is Larry Binion, averaging 34 yards per punt. Alabama has blocked 9 kicks last year, already 3 kicks this year. Binion standing at his 15. He knows the stats, gets the ball, gets the punt away, hits it high and long, and backing up to make the catch at the 21-yard line. Alabama gets to the 25, and that's it. No, on up to the 28-yard line as Vaughn returns a fine punt by Larry Binion of 49 yards.
Boy, they had a collision down there, John. It looked like a couple of Tennessee players.
4-1. Tennessee 5-1 overall coming into this game. Alabama's loss by 1 point to Arkansas. Tennessee's loss to Florida, which earlier today defeated Auburn in the state of Alabama. It's a big football day here, as this will be the kickoff. He hits it long, drills it very well. Summers will make the catch at the 5. 10. 15. Not much there. He just lowers his head and booms it out to the 23-yard line, where Alabama tries to rip the ball away from left to right as you listen, with the ball spotted at the 23-yard line. Alabama has suffered 2 turnovers in the game, 2 fumbles recovered by Tennessee. The Volunteers have fumbled the ball away 1 time to Alabama, but Alabama then, moving deep in Tennessee territory, fumbled it back. And Bergdorf has not returned to action since he was blasted and the fumble occurred. Tennessee first down and 10. Ball at the Volunteer 23-yard line. Alabama dancing around defensively. This is Manning, back to throw off play action. Dumps the pass out here, pulled down behind the line by Joey Kent. And Kent then is able to maneuver forward for only about 2 yards to the 25. And the Balls now lead by 14, 21-7. Manning again, this time against a four-man front. 2 receivers to the right, 2 to the left. Alabama rotates his secondary. Manning to throw. Pass across the middle is, did he catch it? We'll wait and see. They're asking, the officials are looking at one another across the way to see whether it's a trap or not. The ball is out at the 33-yard line, and it is going to be ruled incomplete. Incomplete. And so it will come back to the 25-yard line. Bill?
Goodness, John. Payback time.
Alabama trailing 21-7. And it will be Tennessee third down and 8 yards to go. As the Volunteers have Jay Graham in there as the tailback. The Alabama crowd coming alive as Peyton Manning looks over now, a six-man Alabama front. Apparently, Alabama coming after Manning, as it has been doing. Manning, here they come. Manning steps up to the near side, throws the ball, intercepted, and then dropped by Alabama at the 30-yard line. Kevin Jackson, and Manning was blasted. He's up on his feet and okay, but Tennessee unable to move with the ball as Alabama, adjusting defensively, almost came up with a big turnover.
Yeah, they're really coming there. Blitz, 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 and coming after him. They're going to have to do something on the quick slants or something in there. Peyton's not getting time to do much of anything. The cornerbacks and, as I said, the defensive backs are moving up, playing everybody close, and they're covering up the receivers.
It will be Binion in the punt. Alabama with 10 men to rush. Here's the snap. The punt is away by Binion. Wobbly spiral. Back there, Vaughn will let the ball bounce. He then scrambles after the ball and falls on it to protect it at the 32-yard line of the Crimson Tide. Linebackers goes back to a four-man front out of the shotgun. This will be Kitchens coming to the near side, wants to shovel a pass, but will instead run to the near side and is belted out of bounds as he gets to the 28-yard line. They wanted to go with the underhand Utah pass. Jonathan Brown is the man who chases him down. Tennessee had clogged up the middle. And so it will be Alabama fourth down, and probably into the game to attempt the field goal will be Michael Proctor, who thus far this year is 7 of 7, his longest being 45. And this will be right at that mark, actually a little more than 45 yards into the wind, Michael Proctor. In this quarter, Alabama 104 total yards, Tennessee only 17. A complete turnabout. 21-7 the score. Proctor will be attempting the field goal. The kick by Proctor is in the air, and the kick by Proctor is no sir-ree. No good. And so Tennessee will get the ball. It was a tough wind, Bill, tough wind, and that was right at his longest, as we said. And so Tennessee will get the ball, first down and 10 to go. This broadcast is authorized under the broadcasting rights granted by the University of Tennessee through host communication from right to left. The give goes to Jay Graham, and Graham cracks over right guard, starting at the 28, ending up at the 32. Kendrick Burton and Chris Webb change that hood, team up on the tackle. Gain right at 5 yards, actually. They move the ball to the 33 on the spot. And Tennessee at that point will have it second down and a good 5 yards to go. Graham now, 7 carries, 26 yards. As the balls come to the line against a five-man front again, Price is a man in motion from right to left. Manning gives the ball off to the fullback and cracking forward is Lane, and he is popped and dropped after getting the ball only to the 35-yard line. Plus he went 80 yards, Manning to Kent. Now Kent wide to the right side, double covered. This is Alabama jumping around defensively. Manning looks for Kent. There's the pass going deep on the hitch and go. Kent pulls it down, complete. And he moves to the 42-yard line. You could see it coming. You could feel that Tennessee was going to go with a hitch, and it was Manning who hitched. As, actually, Kent hitched, so did Manning. And then he looped the pass downfield for a big gain and a first down.
He just laid it up in between the double coverage, John. The deep man was laying way back there, and he just hit it in between the two people, two defenders.
23 yards on the pass from Manning to Kent. And with 1:49 to go, Tennessee goes into its two-minute first-half drill, leading 21-7. Alabama, three down linemen. In something of a prevent, they may blitz. Let's see. Manning fakes the draw, looks across the middle, is stripped. There's a scramble for the football at the 43-yard line. As Manning was looking to throw, the ball was stripped by Kelvin Moore, and there's a scramble for that loose ball. Manning was one of those diving in there on top of it, and Tennessee has retained possession. Left side, Alabama now with four down linemen. Manning out, might have been a bust pass downfield, pull down, yanked by Tennessee's Maurice Staley. Staley makes the catch at the 40. Staley moves to the 35, fights his way down close to the 30-yard line, and is tackled at that point. The clock should be stopped. I don't know. Because it was obviously a first down, and the officials stand there and talk about it, and 4 seconds run off the clock.
Yeah, it's down to 51 now. They let it run off. You're exactly right, John. He was past the mark without any problem.
We have timeout on Tennessee.
Tennessee asks for the timeout. 10:30 p.m. Sports South Cable, Tuesday, 6:30. Tennessee with the ball. It will be Manning on first down and 10. Long count. He's changing the play. The play clock is down to 8 seconds. Manning for Tennessee, being pressured, throws the ball across the middle, complete. Ball down at the 15, at the 5, at the 4, at the 3, at the 2, at the 1. Give him 6. Touchdown, Marcus Nash. Manning stood in there. They were coming after him. He stood there. He ripped that football. Nash pulled her down and rides in to score. And Tennessee goes on a brilliant drive.
You know, it looked like that was almost the same pattern that Joey Kent scored on the opening play, John, inside there. He was getting really strong pressure coming from the backside. I thought he might get to him before he could make the release, but he didn't, and he was right on money.
Big play. Peyton Manning, his third touchdown pitch in this contest. As the Volunteers use a timeout to get the proper alignment for the extra point attempt. 43 ticks to go in the first half. Tennessee has one timeout left in the first half of this game. And that drive for the Volunteers just really executed with brilliance. It was initially Graham for 5. Then it was Lane for 2. A big third down completion from Manning to Kent on that hitch and go. 4:23. Manning was dumped, minus 1. Then Manning to Staley, and that was just Staley's catch, a key play in this game.
Yeah, that was a remarkable job. I'll tell you what, the receiver's doing a terrific job for Peyton. He's standing in there making the good calls, and they're making the catches for him, getting open.
Alabama, has it changed its defense again, or is Manning adapting to the change?
Well, I think in that particular series, it looked like they backed off a little bit, John. They wasn't coming at him as strong, and they had changed their offense up, put in a tight end and so forth around a little bit, but nice drive.
Tennessee leading 27-7. This will be Jeff Hall for the extra point. He hits it high enough, long enough, straight enough. It's good. Tennessee 28, Alabama 7. 43 seconds to go in the first half of the game. 2 minutes 18 seconds, the length of the touchdown drive that marched 72 yards in 6 plays, with a touchdown coming. Peyton Manning to Marcus Nash kicking off, as deep will go West and Fagan for Alabama, as the Volunteers convert the touchdown after Alabama failed on a field goal try. It will be Hall to kick off for the first time, wind at his back. Alabama's defense had throttled Tennessee in the second quarter, as you mentioned a moment ago, only 17 yards in the second quarter for Tennessee. But then the Vols take it downfield to score and now lead by a score of 28-7. It will be Hall to kicking it off. It's going to be very, very short. Alabama, who's up there, will be pulled down by Johnson, the big tight end. He's got running room. This is Johnson making the catch at the 35, moves it back to the 40, and he's tackled as he gets there by Sean Summers, as Tennessee just kicked it short.
Yeah, I don't think that was intentional. John, that other thing just popped up there. Could have very easily gave Alabama a great field position. I think he just missed the kick. It only went down the field about 10 or 15 yards.
Although in Hall's defense, it appeared to me that he did not take his normal run-up. He only took a 3-step run to kick it off. Anyway, Alabama, with 38 seconds to go, will have the ball at the tied 40-yard line, trailing 28-7. This will be Kitchens out of the shotgun, stepping up, looking, being pursued from the backside, and he is sacked. He is sacked by Steve White. May not actually be ruled as a sack because he got back to the line of scrimmage, but he was tackled by Whiteline. Tennessee into a prevent with only 3 down linemen to rush. Kitchens out of the shotgun, throws the ball, and it just comes bounding upfield as he lost the handle on the ball, obviously, and the ball slipped off of his hands as he released the pass. Tennessee leads Bama by a score of 28-7. Alabama out of the shotgun, third down. With time, Kitchens. Pass down and out is grabbed on a dive by Shisham, the fullback, who was the safety valve receiver, and Alabama's got to say, well, let's don't risk anything else. Kitchens says, no, let's go for it. The clock is down to 6 seconds and counting. And Alabama lining up. Kitchens wants to get a play away. And the snap will go to him. This is Kitchens on what will be the final play. Is looking, and he will be sacked. So it was Tennessee's Shane Burton picking up his third sack of the year as the first half comes to a close. And Tennessee started fast, slowed, and ended with a rush as well. Look at Ole Miss. Deep will be West and Fagan for Alabama. On the year, West averaging 19 yards per return, and Fagan averaging right at 13. It has been Fagan who has returned them in this game. Tennessee leads 28-7 as the second half is set to get underway. The Volunteers wearing white with orange numerals. Alabama, the crimson jerseys with white numerals. Alabama football broadcasts are done by Eli Gold, who does the play-by-play. Doug Layton, Jerry Duncan, longtime play-by-play announcer John Forty, hosts the pregame show for the Crimson Tide. We're set to go now, and it will be Hall to kick off. And the second half is underway as Hall hits it downfield. It will be corralled by West, who fumbles the ball, scampers after it at the 15, breaks it to the 20, and is finally ridden out of bounds in the vicinity of the 24-yard line. It was Dustin Moore on the coverage unit who makes the stop. So it will be for Alabama, first down and 10 to go, at the Crimson Tide 24-yard line. And at quarterback, it will be Freddie Kitchens, who came on in relief of the starter Brian Bergdorf after Alabama fell behind 21-0. Riddle will be at tailback. Chisholm is the fullback. Receivers to the left, Brown to the right, Malone. Tennessee, four down linemen. We'll check that defensive alignment. Kitchen off play action is back to throw. Long pass downfield is going to be incomplete. Intended to a double covered Curtis Brown as Deron Jenkins was back there protecting. White and DeMario. Second down 10. Alabama splitting the running back. Riddle and Chisholm. This will be Kitchen running with the ball, broken play as he comes out pivoting left and actually got bumped by Riddle. I'm not sure exactly what the play was, but whatever it was, it didn't work, bringing the play for the Crimson Tide as it will be he coming wide to the near side along with Brown. They go into a shotgun on third down and 9. Alabama with Kitchen. Back to throw. Pass upfield is complete. Pulled down by Brown in first down territory at the 39-yard line. Good throw by Kitchens to Brown, who makes the catch in front of Terry Fair. It's a first down.
Yeah, they kind of drop back. Tennessee playing a little bit. So.
At the Alabama 39-yard line. Still in the shotgun. Tennessee with four down linemen. Ball of the near hash mark. Back to throw. Here's the pass. It is going to be caught again by Brown, who makes the catch at the 50-yard line. And that will be enough for the first down. In Alabama, trailing 28-7. Tennessee brings a linebacker up on the near side. Back to throw will be Kitchen. Pass across the middle is complete. Yanked down this time by Chad Key. It's an 11-yard gain to the Tennessee 39-yard line. Hines makes the tackle on Key, but Alabama, three straight first down pass flag. They had 12 men out there. I didn't want to mention that in view of what's going on, but nevertheless, they had 12 men and the flag flies, and it's going to be one of those illegal substitution type deal.
We have a dead ball foul, substitution infraction against the offense, 5-yard penalty, so still first
here's
down.
The 5-yard penalty against Alabama in the third quarter. Running backs will be split, flankers left and right. Tennessee brings a linebacker over the outside. This will be back to throw. The quarterback Kitchens and Tennessee, as we said, brought the linebacker up. Here they come. He is sacked. It's Scott Galyon who crept up and comes in to dump him back at the 50-yard line.
He took a pretty good shot that time, too, John. His three white shirts got to him. Little came from the outside in there. Good pressure that time. He had no chance to get it away.
So it will be second down and right at 21 yards to go for the Tide as Tennessee adjusts its defense and comes after him. Kitchens will align himself in the shotgun. And now Alabama has four receivers in the game. Two to the right, one to the left against the four-man front. Kitchens out of the shotgun. Back to look. Pass downfield is going to be intercepted at the 30. Back to the 35. Back to the 40. Fighting his way to the 42-yard line. Terry Fair. Played it beautifully. Absolutely played it beautifully. Interception to Garland.
They set the trap for him and he went, John. They had double coverage out there. He came up like he was going to get him room to the outside. He threw the ball and then they closed on it. Good interception, good defense.
So Tennessee will hand the ball, leading 28-7. Turnover number 3 against Alabama, which obviously builds its concept on out turning the other team. Tennessee will send a man in motion as the Volunteers set up a screen pass to the left side. Gets a block. He's at the 45. He's at the 50. Down to the 47-yard line goes Greg Kuyler. Yet another Tennessee receiver who got a block from the freshman Peerless Price, who was the man in motion. Tennessee has Kent and Nash, McCullough. Benji Shuler is into the game now for the Volunteers as a slot man to the right side. Handoff goes to Graham. Sutter step. Gets to the outside. Chases past the 45. Battles his way as he pounds it down to the 41-yard line of the Crimson Tide. Fernando Bryan makes the tackle, but Graham was slowed but not denied.
They got some pretty good blocking over there on the strong side of Tennessee's changing their formation up with the tight end there and trying to take that blitz away. That quick screen, but prior to that, that's the kind of thing it can slow that blitz down.
Again on the play of right at 5 yards. Tennessee second down, a short five to go. And the officials indicate that Alabama has asked for a timeout. Back to play, second down, a short five for Tennessee after the timeout by Alabama. This is Manning getting off to Graham. Starts right, nothing there. Good defensive reaction in the middle by Alabama. As Graham was trying to look for an opening, he started to the right, was going to cut back against the grain, but Kendrick Burton was right there to stop him. 38 into a shotgun. Alabama with four down linemen. Out of the shotgun, this will be Manning, and here comes Alabama breaking through. And it is Kelvin Moore saying, I was drawn off. I was drawn off. And the officials will again get into a conference. Alabama has... Let's see what it is. It's going to be illegal procedure. Tennessee did, in fact, draw him off foul. Outside sees Tennessee with two wide receivers, one left, one right. Manning looking, pumping across the middle, pull down. Made catch made at the 40, fighting his way, struggling. Dustin Moore fighting, pounding, reaching, scrambling, and did he make it? It's very, very close. Let's see what kind of spot Tennessee gets here, as the officials are going to look it over and say there will be a measurement. They still haven't spotted. Now they spotted the ball. I don't know. It was Dustin Moore, the tight end, coming across the middle. And Tennessee's Peyton Manning is there shaking his head, a little perturbed, I think, as they're going to haul it in, Bill Anderson. It will be very close. Tennessee leads in the game 28-7 with 9:53 to go in the third. Chain stretched, and it is inches shy of the first down. Inches shy. Got maybe an extra offensive lineman in there on the right side to give Tennessee really sort of an unbalanced look. Tennessee leads 28-7. Fourth down, inches. Manning, the quarterback. Will he sneak? Yes. Did he make it? Let's wait till he spot it. Never anticipate anything here, as Manning just runs right behind the right guard. And I think, Bill, he was able to... Yes, yeah. First down, Tennessee.
That one had to be good unless they spotted it where his feet wound up.
So it's going to be for Tennessee first down and 10 at the 37-yard line. Big Bubba Miller, Jeff Smith. Tennessee just overpowering in there with so many offensive linemen to just nudge the ball for the first down. So the Volunteers have it first down and 10 at the Alabama 37-yard line. Alabama creeps a wing back up on the near side, and Tennessee reacts, giving the ball to Jay Graham, starting to the left. It's very tough going in the middle. He veers back right and crunches the ball inside the 35-yard line in the grasp of Kevin Jackson. Alabama continues to jump around with their defensive alignment, and Tennessee that time went with the drive through the left side for a gain of a little over two. Graham now 9 carries, 32 yards. He has gone over 100 yards rushing in 5 of Tennessee's 6 games. But it is tough against a very, very stout Alabama defense. Well schooled defensively. Alabama 5-man front. Manning looking to throw. Pass downfield is caught by the tight end, who is Scott Pfeiffer. He makes the catch short of the 30-yard line and is tackled at that point. And again, we'll wait for them to spot the ball. Dwayne Rudd and Kevin Jackson converge to make the tackle, and it will be spotted at the 31-yard line on the right or west hash mark. Tennessee needs to get the ball to the 27 for the first. Third down and 4. As the Vols nicking at the Alabama defense, twice the past 2 completed passes have been to the tight end. Manning now has the call, will bring his team to the line, skips Kent wide to the left side. Jay Graham is the single running back. A wing back is set on the right. Alabama, four down linemen to rush. Here comes the blitz from the near side. Pass across the middle is underthrown. It was intended for a slanting Maurice Staley. He had the angle, but the pass was underthrown, and it's incomplete. On the year, his longest being 53. Tennessee then adjusts, trying to draw Alabama off sides by shifting the tight ends. It didn't work. And so Tennessee's just going to let the clock count down, and there the Volunteers go for the delay of game. Tennessee is stacking it in tight to try to take away the lane for Alabama on the block, but the outside man has it. The punt is away by Binion. It's high, and it will be Tennessee chasing it down. The ball bounds at the 10 and rolls to the 5 and is downed by the University of Tennessee Volunteers at the Alabama 3-yard line.
Perfect.
33-yard punt.
Hit. Perfect.
So Alabama deep in its own territory will line up in the I formation with 7:45 to go in the third quarter. Tennessee leads 28-7. Alabama with Kitchen off play action looking deep. Here's a long, long pass. It's going to be battled for, and it will be ruled as there's a penalty marker dropped. And let's see exactly what the call will be. Todrick Malone was the intended receiver, and he was up against Terry Fair. And my guess is, well, I don't want to guess.
Well, it looks like it's going to be against Alabama. That surprised me, John, because Alabama, the receiver, got in there on him, and there was a little bit of contact. The flag was late coming out. I felt sure it would be on Tennessee, but I missed that one.
Well, I saw it as Malone shoving.
Yeah, I think you're right, obviously.
Well, of course. Am I ever wrong?
You have a better angle at it over there.
Exactly. I'm 10 feet away from you. So it will be a penalty against Alabama of half the distance to the goal for offensive pass interference.
We have pass interference against the offense. Penalized half the distance to the goal from the previous spot. Still first in.
So it's going to be first down for Alabama. Only, in essence, a 1 or 2 yard penalty on the play. But Alabama, trailing 28-7, will have the ball. Offensive pass interference on Alabama. Into the I formation. This will be the give going to the fullback, Shisham, who pounds ahead, starting at the 1.5 and makes it out to about the 4. And he's tackled by Gallion and Al Wilson, the freshman from Jackson, who's in there defending for Tennessee. Alabama has 4 players, actually 5 from the state of Tennessee, 1 not dressed. Curtis Alexander has had all kinds of injury problems, great running back. Fernando Bryant, Reggie Grimes, Calvin Hall, Josh Schwartz. Swords, it should be. Back to throw in the end zone. This will be the pass upfield, caught at the 10 and fighting his way to about the 13-yard line will be Dennis Riddle. I think he has enough for the first down. It was Jesse Sanders who chases him down as Kitchen almost was pounded in the end zone, stepped forward and throws the pass, and as they bring it in, it is not going to be enough for the first. As they spot the ball, it's about a yard shy. And so Alabama, trailing 28-7, 6:59 to go, will hand the ball third down and a short yard, really, inside the Alabama 13-yard line. They break the huddle. They come up in the I formation. Riddle is the tailback. Tennessee crams it up tight. This will be Riddle trying the right side. I'm not sure. He cracked it. I think he got the first out. Running behind on the right side, DeMario and White. Tyrone Hines submarines to make the tackle on him. 30-yard line. This will be Kitchens against the blitz, and he's in trouble, but he steps up. Now he's swinging out to the near side, throws the ball. It is complete. Pulled down by Sisson, the fullback, as Kitchens was hit twice and was able to withstand both tackles from the blitz and picked up Shisham and threw the ball to him on the near side, and it will be a gain of 2 yards on the play.
He's hard to get down again. They had a pretty good hit on him that time. He got hit pretty solid. They just couldn't bring him to the ground.
Freddie Kitchen, 6'2", 230, came on back in the first quarter when Tennessee jumped out to a 21-0 lead, and it is he bringing his team to the line on second down and 8 yards to go at the Tennessee 28-yard line. Again, Tennessee dancing around defensively. This is Kitchen looking. Pass down and out is incomplete. Stumbling and falling as he makes his cut across the way is Todrick Malone. Tennessee had a player breaking, Deron Jenkins, on the ball. Simply could not get there in time. And it will be third down and 8 yards to go. For Alabama, in the air now, 21 of 34 for 207. And
Most of that has been Kitchens. Bergdorf, when he left the game, was 4 of 5 for 26 and an interception. Kitchen, 8 of 13 for 96 in the second half. Here it is, third down and 8. Kitchens out of the shotgun. Tennessee creeps on the right side, back to throw. This is Kitchens. Across the middle, passes deflected down, then caught by Key on the deflection, and he holds on to the ball at the 15-yard line. Outstanding play by Chad Key. As the ball got there, he juggled it because he was hit by Tennessee's Torrey Noel, but Key reached up and pulled down the deflection line. Back to the shotgun. Tennessee coming with the blitz. This is Kitchens. Man open in the end zone. Pass overthrown. Is there a flag in the house? No. It was intended for Brown. Went far over his head. Incomplete as Tennessee probably troubled Kitchens with the blitz.
Yeah, they had some pressure coming at him. I don't know whether he was trying to throw that away or not, but it wasn't anywhere close to the receiver getting to him.
This drive for Alabama began, as we mentioned moments ago, back at the 3-yard line of the tie, tied after the pooch punt by Binion was downed. The 14th play coming up here on second down and 10 at the Tennessee 15-yard line. Kitchens, play action, now on a delay, hands it off to Riddle, breaks a tackle, change that, this will be Madden carrying the ball through the left side. Madden at the 15, at the 10, at the 5, touchdown by Alabama. As he breaks a tackle at the line and races downfield to score on the 200, a freshman from Town Creek. And it is he who scores the touchdown. And it will be Watts to kick off for Alabama with 2:04 still left to go in the third quarter of this game. 5 minutes, 41 seconds, the length of the drive for the touchdown by Alabama. 28-14, the Tide will kick off. Tennessee again with people up there at the 50-yard line. The ball, of course, spotted at the 35. Anticipating the possibility of an onside kick. Let's see what it will be. Alabama kicks it away. High. Tennessee with Summers under the ball at the 5. Summers up the middle. 10, 15, 20. Gets the ball to the 25-yard line, at which point Tennessee will have it first down and 10 to go. Andre Short was there to make the tackle. So Alabama's defensive unit coming into the game. The crowd coming alive for the Crimson Tide. After an outstanding 97-yard drive. And so Tennessee will hand the ball first down and 10 to go at the 25-yard line, leading 28-14 with 1:58 to go. Manning brings his team to the line with a single running back behind him. Alabama with four down linemen to rush. Ball on the right hash mark. This is Manning. Crowd deafening. Handoff Graham comes to the near side at the corner. 25-30. Outside 35-40. 45-50. 45-40. 35-30. 25-20. 15, 10, 5. Yes, he went all the way. Is there a marker in the field? There is no marker on the field. Touchdown, Tennessee!
Wow.
75 yards. Graham gets to the corner, and he turns the corner, and then he outlegs everybody down the near sideline as Jay Graham rings up TD number 8 of the year. This one, 75 yards, his longest run as a Volunteer, and Tennessee builds its lead to 34-14.
He'll probably never have a better one at a better time, John. I tell you, they turned the corner. Alabama was coming at him up there. Everybody on the inside, they gambled a little bit. He got outside. He's gone.
Hall for the extra point. Give it to him. 10-second station identification. This is the Vol Network.
Win $1,000 cash Monday at 7:15. It's the incredible Monday Morning Birthday Bucks on 107.7 WIVK-FM, Knoxville.
From Legion Field, this is John Wood and Bill Anderson sending you the play-by-play. Alabama marches 97 yards in 15 plays, as I recall, 13 plays. Tennessee then sees Alabama pull within 14 points. Tennessee comes right back. One play, 75 yards. Jay Graham, touchdown, Big Orange.
Boy, he turned the corner. It was a beautiful run. Really, he kind of came out of there clean. He didn't have anybody blocking for him. He just made it around the corner and just split it all the way out, ran everybody for the score. The only thing about that, the defensive people are looking up. They're sucking wind. They got to get right back out there now.
Tennessee's defensive unit, of course, was out there on the field during that 97-yard drive by Alabama. And here Graham puts them right back out there as he has now gone 107 yards in 10 carries. So in six games, he has gone 100 yards or more, as Tennessee leads now 35-14. And Noel and Fair and Austin accept when Tennessee goes to a nickel package. Back to throw. This will be Kitchen. He is sacked. He is sacked. Little got there, then cleaning up was Duff. Sacked back at the 15-yard line.
They got to him. Looks like Tennessee, one of the linemen there, is getting up a little bit slower, but I guess he's going to be all right. Good pressure. Again, he was about to break loose until the second man got there. Little got there to put the finishing touch on it.
1:11 to go in the third quarter with Tennessee leading 35-14. The Crimson Tide going into the shotgun. Tennessee creeps a safety up on the right side. This will be Kitchens under a blitz throwing upfield. It is incomplete. Tennessee said, I almost had an interception. That being Terry Fair, and he almost did, as he cut in front of the intended receiver, Curtis Brown, almost had the pick.
They were trying to, they set the trap in there with the double over there and almost had it, as you said, John. That ball was thrown a little bit too low for anybody to get it. Otherwise, I believe it might have been an interception.
As it is, it will be third down and 17 to go. The sack moments ago on first down, minus 7. It was second and 17. Now it is third and 17. At the tied 15-yard line with 55 seconds to go in the third quarter of the game. Into the shotgun goes Freddie Kitchens. Kitchens looking, waiting. Long pass downfield is going to be incomplete, intended to a widening Chad Key. And after making the pass, Kitchens was dropped as Tennessee came after him pretty well. It will be fourth down as Tennessee thwarts the Tide. And drifting deep is Sean Summers, as into the game will come Hayden Stockton to punt for the Crimson Tide. Into the wind with 49 seconds to go in the third quarter, and Tennessee leading 35-14. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 11 players for Tennessee. Here's the snap. Hayden gets the punt away. Summers camping under it. Should make a fair catch, but doesn't. Makes the catch and will run it back. He's at the 45. He's to the 50 and down to the 48-yard line, where Alabama's John Walters makes the tackle on a courageous Sean Summers.
I tell you, he has a lot of courage. John, he took that ball, and they were breathing right down on him. He just sidestepped the first guy and picked up a little extra yards.
The punt good for 43 yards. The return by Summers good for 10. 38 seconds remain in the third quarter of the game. And Tennessee, with the wind at its back in the third period, now leads by a score of 35-14. Tennessee went up 21-0, 21-7, 28-7, 28-14, 35-14. Manning sets up a screen. Pulled out on the right side. Now Tennessee on the flea flicker. Pass downfield is complete! As the pass was thrown by Greg Kuyler, who took the lateral from Manning. And then...
pass was complete.
It was Nash who threw the ball, and it was Kuyler who made the catch.
It wasn't the best of passes, but he made a great catch on it.
It was Manning lateraling the ball to Nash. He then throws the ball downfield to Kuyler, who makes the catch at the 20, and he's tackled at the 19-yard line. Tennessee on the flea flicker, and it will be for the Volunteers first down and 10 at the Alabama 19. Single running back is Graham. Manning across the middle, pass complete. Pulled down at the 11-yard line by Nash. He's at the 10, and he is upended as he gets to the 6-yard line by John Walters. That will be enough for another first down. Just that quick slam.
Quick slam. That'll stop that blitzing up the middle, John. Of course, they pretty much got Alabama back on their heels right now.
As the third quarter comes to a close, and the Volunteers lead by a score of 35-14. A break for our stations along the line. We'll be back with the fourth and final period in just 1 minute. End to this point with 200 in just 1 minute. End to this point with 276 yards, 289 yards passing in this game. Peyton Manning moves past Condridge Holloway to become ninth all-time in passing at the University of Tennessee. And he's had...
he's just getting started, John. He's going to break every record there is, I believe.
Peyton Manning will bring his team to the line. Wide right goes Kent. Tennessee into a power eye set to the left side. Alabama goes into a seven-man front. This is Graham trying the left side, gets to the corner, then slides inside, is really blasted from behind, but not until Graham had moved the ball from the 6 to the 4. Tennessee leads, second down and goal at the Alabama 4-yard line. Two receivers to the right, two to the left. Tennessee out of the shotgun with Manning 6 yards deep. Alabama bringing the linebackers. Manning looking, sets up a screen to the near side, brilliantly covered by Alabama. And though completed to Maurice Staley, Tennessee loses a yard or two on the play. Outstanding defensive play, Fernando Bryant.
Zatash,
4 for 78. It will be Tennessee to the line. No running back, 5 receivers in the game for the Volunteers, and Alabama's going to come after Peyton Manning, would be my guess. Manning standing, looking, throwing the ball into the end zone. Up goes the Volunteer. It is incomplete, intended for Maurice Staley, but it was far over his head and falls incomplete. So into the game for Tennessee will come Jeff Hall. On the year, Hall is 10 of 13 in field goal tries. He has 5 extra points in this game, so he is 31 of 32 in that department. This will be a 25-yard field goal from the left hash mark. 35 to 14 the score. Tennessee leads the Crimson Tide here at Birmingham. Holding will be Price. Ingram will snap. Alabama, great blocker. Here's the kick by Hall. He gets it away. The kick, good.
25-yard field goal.
2 minutes 12 seconds. The Vols will kick off, and it will be Hall to kick, and Fagan is back there along with West for the Crimson Tide with 13:26 to go in the game. Lots and lots of time. Tennessee jumped off to a 7-0, 14-0, 21-0 first quarter lead and led at halftime 28-7. Now 38-14. Here's Hall, the field goal kicker, 4 yards deep in the end zone. West brings it out. Goal line, 5, 10, 15, shoved out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Pass across the middle is going to be juggled and dropped by the aforementioned Malone. So that tandem had worked so very well in Atala High School, and this time Malone, Bill Anderson coming across the middle, was open, just couldn't get Alabama second down and 10. Now they go into a shotgun set. Kitchens looking, pass across the middle, juggle, could be intercepted, is by Tennessee. Picked off at the 34. With the football, this will be Al Wilson. Wilson still with the ball. Change that to Ron Jenkins. Jenkins gets the interception at the 30, moves back down to the 25, and is shoved out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Tennessee first down, 10 to go.
Another big turnover for Tennessee, John. Great field position now. The defense is going to be a lot of pressure on the Alabama defense to come right back out here and hold them out of the end zone again.
Well, they're going into the shotgun. Graham is deployed to the right side as a possible runner. Movement. And I think the Alabama man jumped, but Tennessee's left tackle moved, reacting to it. It will be Tennessee leading 38-14. Manning out of the shotgun again. Looking, waiting. Pass complete down to the 20-yard line to a stumbling Joey Kent. A gain on the play of right at 8 yards, but keep in mind Tennessee had 15 to go for Horn as well, who is here. Of course, Horn's out with the injury. He's here, but will not be playing. Pass downfield, complete to Tennessee. Pulled down by Marcus Nash, who makes the catch to the 15. He saunters down to the 10, and he's shoved out of bounds just short of the 10-yard line by Kevin Jackson. As it's Manning on target again, connecting with Marcus Nash, who has 2 touchdowns in the game, and the Volunteers will have it first down and 10, not goal, first down and 10 at the 10 and 1 foot yard line. I think Tennessee might be able to make a first. Let's wait till they stretch the chain. Tennessee could conceivably make a first, but it would be less than a football length away. So it's first down for the Volunteers, almost goal to go. Tennessee leading 38-14. Manning gives the ball off to Graham, starts to the left, and he's dropped. Good defense by Alabama. It was Kevin Jackson who comes up to make the tackle on. Out of the shotgun, back with Manning under the center. A wing back to the near side in the tight end, who is Scott Pfeiffer. Manning, a delay, gives to Graham. Cuts to the near side and is tackled for a loss at the 14-yard line by Kevin Jackson. But Alabama has stopped Tennessee 2 consecutive rushes. Here comes the blitz. Manning in trouble, breaks free, and is now going to be sacked at the 21-yard line, the 24th of the game. Tennessee will not get the field goal away. Well, they should have blown the whistle, did they? The kick is up and good. Where's the call? Well, one never knows. the shot, play clock had ticked away, but the field goal is up and it is good. 41-14, Bill.
I don't know. You know, we sat here and looked at the zero, hit the clock. Tennessee, I guess, what goes around comes around. Tennessee got the break that time.
And so it will be Tennessee leading 41-14 on the field goal by Jeff Hall. And we should have stayed on top of it, obviously, but I was watching the play clock, and it was a zero before the ball was snapped. But nevertheless, after the snap, the kick by Hall is perfect. And Tennessee converts that turnover into a field goal to build the lead to 41-14. And Tennessee will be kicking off yet another time. 10:09 to go in the football game. The white-clad Volunteers racing onto the field to do the kicking. And deep again will go west for Alabama, standing back along with Fagan at the goal line. Next week, Tennessee has an open date. The next game for the Volunteers against South Carolina. And that will be 2 weeks hence in Knoxville, an afternoon contest at present. It will be Hall to kick off. And here's the kick by Hall. Hits this one well. This will be 4 yards deep in the end zone, and West will down it. And so Alabama will hand the ball first down at 10 to go at its 20-yard line after the touchback. Tennessee is plus 27 on the scoreboard, 41-14. Kitchens brings his team to the line against a four-man front. In the I formation with Riddle, the tailback. Kitchens off play action. Back to throw in trouble is sacked. Great stunt on the near side by Shane Burton, who pivoted to the inside and really nailed it.
Yeah, well, you haven't seen Tennessee lineman doing much of that technique. And he put a spin move, started to one direction. The lineman, offensive lineman, picked him up, and he just spun out of it. When he spun out, he was right into the Kitchens' face.
The fifth sack of the ball game for Tennessee. A loss back to the 13 minus 7. And it will be second down and 17 to go for the Tide, trailing 41-14 with 9 minutes and 30 seconds to go. In the shotgun, Kitchens steps up, sacked. Getting him from the backside. Tennessee just overpowering this time with Anthony Hampton. Coming from the backside, and once more, Kitchens is nailed. And Tennessee defensively using, as we said, a lot of people, Sanders and Kidd and Hampton and Wilson and Hines and Gallion and Peoples as linebackers, not at the same time, but a lot of people playing defensively in this game.
Yeah, they've got a lot of people, and I think that's making a difference to Alabama. They're trying to keep some pretty fresh people in there. Got those quick feet, and they run right by them that time.
Third down, 20 yards to go at the 10. Kitchens being pressured again, steps up, has time. Pass upfield is going to be intercepted. Tennessee picked off at the 40, and his knee goes down as he makes the interception, he being Raymond Austin. Kitchens threw the ball long. Austin just patrolling it, is there to make yet another turnover for Tennessee, the third interception of the game. And with 8:39 to go, Tennessee leads by a score of 41-14, and the quarterback remains Peyton Manning.
Well, that's what happens, John, to you when you get depressed and trying to catch up when you're down. He threw that ball in desperation. There was nobody down there, and it was an easy interception for Tennessee. But irregardless of that, Tennessee's defense has played themselves proud tonight. They've done a heck of a job all the way around.
Six sacks to this point by Tennessee, so that on the year the Volunteers have a total of 24 sacks. The ball's to the line into an I formation. Change that, single running back will be Graham. Change through the right side of the line. Graham pops the ball, starting there at the 42. He's at the 40, moves it down to the 35, and is tackled as he gets to the 33-and-a-half yard. Alabama coming in 4-and-1, Tennessee 5-and-1. Into an I formation for the Vols this time on short yardage. Manning, fullback gets the ball, pops it to the right side of the line. This is Chester Ford. Ford has the ball at the 30. Ford gets to the 25 and will be stopped at that point by a host of Crimson Tide defenders, but Ford says, I want that football, and he pops out of there with it, but he's got a first down.
That's a big night for Tennessee, I tell you that. They've played extremely well on both sides of the ball, John, and they've really taken it to Alabama.
Chester Ford, normally a blocker, this time a runner, and he's picked up a first down. Coming into the game, 6 carries, 19 yards, now 8 carries for 24 yards. And it will be Tennessee, first down and 10 at the Alabama 25-yard line. Wide to the right goes freshman Fearless Price. Graham, the single running back. Alabama creeps linebackers, could be blitzing. Manning senses that, gives it off to Graham, cutting to the near side in trouble, and will be chased down and shoved out of bounds by Ralph Statton. Then a penalty marker is down after he was shoved out of bounds at the 29-yard line. Tennessee has 20 first downs in this game. The Vols lead 41-14. Tennessee to the line against the five-man front. Handoff goes. This is Jay Graham in trouble again, and he is nailed and dropped as Alabama just comes knowing Tennessee's going to run the ball, leading 41-14. Van Bodden gets the Manning against a five-man front. Gives it off to Graham, starts right, cuts to the near side, stiff arms a would-be tackler, but not the second, and he is knocked down as he moves the ball to the 23-yard line. Manning is the quarterback against a four-man rush. Fakes the pitch, Tennessee with a reverse. With the ball, this is Dustin Moore, running through one tackle, running through a tackle, second tackle, reaching out and stretching his way for what could be a first down. Dustin Moore written down by Statton, but there was a battle. And as they spot it, let's see where they're going to bring the ball in. It is, well, they're going to spot the ball again, Bill.
Now, Tennessee hadn't had a good spot all night. Now, they short-legged them.
they spot the ball at the 16-yard line. He's stretched out trying to battle past the 15. Apparently not. So it will be for the Volunteers, fourth down and a yard to go. And Tennessee comes up with Manning bringing his team to the line in a power eye set to the right side. This will be the tailback trying for the first down, and it is Eric Lane, nothing there. He is dropped short of the first down. The Tide reacting. Coming into the game will be Kitchens at quarterback. Legion Field being vacated, Bill Anderson.
By everyone except those wearing orange, John. They're over there. They're loving it.
Alabama with the ball, trailing 41-14, 5:18 to go in the game. The Tide with Kitchens at quarterback against the four-man Tennessee front. Riddle is the running back behind him as Kitchens takes the straight drop. Kitchens looking. Pass across the middle is complete. Yanked down at the 24-yard line by Riddle, and Riddle moves forward to the 25. It will be 2.5 yards short of the first down. Second down upcoming. Tackle made by Jesse Sanders. The Tide lining up without a huddle, trying to get something on the scoreboard, trailing 41-14, inside 5 minutes to go. Ball at the 25. Kitchens looking. Pass downfield is going to be intercepted. Tennessee at the 45. And then after making the interception, he bounces. He being Sean Summers, bounces into one of his own players, and the ball just pops free.
Great play on the ball by Summers over there. He had the thing. He got it. Looked like he had it in hand there for a minute. Then it just bounced up and got away from it.
And so Tennessee, he had a clear shot too, Bill, had he held on to that football.
Oh, he's gone. I think that might have been one reason he lost the handle on it. He was looking to run before he got a hold of it.
So an apparent interception is dropped by Sean Summers. And with 4:47 to go, Alabama has the ball. It will be third down and about a yard and a half to go. Could be running here to pick up the first. The pitch will go to Riddle. Riddle at the corner's got a first down and more. Pops it into the open. Has the ball to the 30, to the 35, to the 40, all the way to the Alabama 43-yard line. Comes Dennis. First down for Alabama. Trailing 41-14, 4:25 to go of the game. Out of the shotgun, Kitchens with time this time. Pass downfield is caught. Penalty marker is down. As the catch is made by Riddle, who is shoved out of bounds by Steve Johnson, but a penalty marker is down. With 4:15 to go, the clock is stopped. 41-14, Tennessee leads Alabama. And the officials again will discuss the infraction. Tennessee next week will be playing, will have an open date, and then in 2 weeks we'll be playing South Carolina in Knoxville. Here's the call.
We have a personal foul against the defense, 15-yard penalty for contact to the face, 15 yards from the end of the run, first down.
And so Alabama not only has the personal foul penalty, but it is assessed from the point where the tackle was made. And so Alabama suddenly has the ball deep in Tennessee territory as the officials are trying to figure out where to spot the ball. Finally, they do at the 36-yard line. And it's going to be first down and 10, Alabama at the Tennessee 36. 4:15 left to go of the game. Into the shotgun again. Kitchens has gone all the way in the second, third, and fourth quarters. Back to throw is Kitchens. Kitchens waiting. Kitchens looking. Pass downfield is incomplete. Again, Tennessee had a man breaking. This time, Sean Summers guilty of the personal foul. Second down and 10. Kitchens, again in the shotgun. Here's the pass underneath, and it is deflected down. Momentarily, it was received by Dennis Riddle. He was popped by Anthony Ride. To the right comes Malone. And then here comes an official in, waving his arms. As they'll have another 1-14. Alabama, 3:53 go to go in the game. Fourth down play for the Tide. The snap, this is Kitchens. Kitchens downfield, the pass is going to be deflected down incomplete. It was deflected by Jenkins, then Tennessee had somebody break on the ball. I think it might have been Johnson. Jenkins is the man who tips it down, intended for Key. And so for Tennessee, it will be first down and 10. And let's see what the alignment will be. Tennessee stops Alabama on a fourth down pass try. And it will be for Tennessee first down at the Volunteer 36.5-yard line. For the Vols, in there at running back will be Mark Levine. Peyton Manning will be the quarterback for the Volunteers. As Tennessee leads 41-14. Alabama defending. First and 10, Tennessee. Levine the tailback. Alabama, four men up close to defend. Levine cuts to the left, spins inside, dives it past the 40 to the 41-yard line. Ending goes to Levine, gets to the outside 40, Levine 45, Levine 50. Levine staggers down to the Alabama 46-yard line before again Floyd makes the tackle. The clock will be stopped for the marking of the first down as Mark Levine, 5'11", 177-pound freshman, picks up the first down with a nice cut to the left side.
Well, obviously now they're just taking it at him with the run, trying to run the clock out. I doubt Manning will throw another pass he didn't in the last series, because no point in taking a chance of getting somebody sacking him back there at this stage.
First and 10, Tennessee at the Alabama 46-yard line into an I formation. This is Levine again, slithering through the right side, gets only a yard this time as he's muscled down by 41-14. And the Volunteers have the ball, second down and 9 yards to go. Long count, Manning gives off to the fullback, cracking straight up the middle. This is Eric Lane, big hole right side, and he grinds it out to the 40-yard line before he's tackled. 3.5 yards short of the first down. Manning, and the crowd comes alive for the sophomore quarterback.
Please meet your party at game number 7.
Tennessee will have Jeremy Bates in there at quarterback. Give goes to the fullback, and this is Eric Lane, cracking through the left side of the line. Change that, Gray Barker, who is in there at fullback, and he carries the ball for a gain of a yard or two. Peyton Manning comes out of the football game. Bill Anderson, standing ovation.
Well, he should get one. He played a Super Bowl game. No question about that. I'm surprised they left him in there as long as they did, John, because the ball game has been decided here for at least two or three series.
53 seconds to go of the game. Now Jermaine Copeland is in at quarterback for Tennessee. He's the freshman. It's going to be fourth down and a yard. Copeland hands off to the fullback, and grinding through the left side of the line will be for Tennessee, Barker, and I think he got the first down. First down, Tennessee, as Gray Barker pounds at left guard, and the Volunteers will have the ball, first down and 10 at the Crimson Tide 35-yard line. Clock is wound, and Tennessee will run one more play, and that will be it. Bates and Copeland both playing, and this will be Bates back in there at quarterback for Tennessee as the Volunteers let everybody into what will be a Volunteer victory. Bates keeps, turns, runs down to the 32-yard line where he is tackled, and the clock is counting as Jeremy Bates carries for the Volunteers. The clock is counting, and Tennessee goes racing, the entire team racing over in front of the Volunteer fans at the north end, northeast corner of the field, as the Volunteers have come to Birmingham, and Tennessee will go home with a 41-14 victory.
This is